What I'd like to talk to you about this morning is how we as teachers can promote intellectual and personal development in our students. I was the very first woman at Vanderbilt University to be made a director of a medical school class. And so there was a lot riding on it. It was important for me to do well because I thought that I represented a class of individuals and needed to do well. And when other people found out that I taught medical students, they would approach me. And even though I'm not a clinician, I was a scientist, people would approach me and they would start telling me things. And one day a woman approached me and she said that she wanted to tell me about something that had happened to her. And this woman's story changed me personally, changed me as a teacher, and I've never taught the same since. So she told me that her husband had gotten sick, and they thought he had the flu, and he'd been sick for about 10 days and he wasn't getting any better. So they had brought him into the emergency room thinking that they would give him antibiotics or they'd do something and he would magically be cured. Over the next 3 days, he had a number of tests and it was determined that he had metastatic cancer and was unlikely to live more than a month or so. And she said that her husband had chosen at the time, this is many years ago, had chosen to have what's called direct infusion chemotherapy into the liver, which is really, really rough on patients. And he had been brought back from one of these treatments, and he was brought back into the room and lying in the bed. And she was in the corner, as she described it to me, and his bed was here. And two residents came into the room and stood on both sides of the bed. These two residents proceeded to have an argument about when he was going to die and what he was going to die of. With one of the residents saying, you know, I think that this guy's heart's going to give out and I'll bet he'll be dead by the end of the week. And the other resident said, no man, did you see the stats this morning from the labs? This guy's kidneys are failing, he'll probably be dead by the end of the day. This was in front of the wife, in front of the patient. And the wife went screaming out of the room to the attending. And the attending's attitude was, look, your husband had just had high-dose chemotherapy directly in the liver. He was probably so out of it, he didn't understand a thing that was said. And she said, well, then maybe you can explain to me why tears were streaming down his face. What's wrong? What happens in between getting accepted to medical school and being a resident? You know what happens in between? Medical school. And I began to think, as I moved away from it a little bit and tried to think about how could medical school be contributing to this, I thought, well, we treat these young people as though we just need to open up their heads and stuff in 10 million facts and then close up their head and send them off. We don't treat them as people. We don't treat the student as a person. We depersonalized the student, and I felt that later on that caused the student to become a physician who depersonalized their patients.